With the release of the new 15-inch M2 MacBook Air, this is definitely exciting times, as this is the very first time Apple is offering MacBooks in different sizes and specs for all types of users. So if you're looking for the best MacBook and not sure what to choose for, in this video, we will help you to decide which is the best MacBook for you. Now, when you're choosing an Apple laptop, Apple divides the laptop series into two lineups. The first one is the MacBook Air lineup. The other one is the professional focus MacBook Pro. And within each lineup, you can do configurations on the CPU, on the RAM, on the storage, and the price will change accordingly. So here are seven major areas to consider. The first area will be the choice of CPU, GPU. Apple MacBooks offer a wide range of CPU and GPU cores, starting from 8 cores all the way up to 38 cores. Generally speaking, if you're mainly using your MacBook for office works, documents like Word, PowerPoint, Excel, emails, web browsing, content consumption like YouTube, Netflix, and you're doing some simple tasks, you can actually consider the MacBook Air lineup. Now, on the other hand, if you're doing more intensive and more heavy-duty tasks, example, photo editing, your video editing, 3D modeling, rendering, animation, or very complex calculations or computations, then you can consider the MacBook Pro lineup. The second area would be RAM. Now, some of you would be thinking, is it better to have more? Is it the more the merrier? So firstly, it's important to understand that for the Apple's new silicon chip, it actually uses unified RAM, which means that the RAM is unified, integrated with the chip, and this greatly improves the speed and performance. This is actually seen in my M1 MacBook Air with 8GB of RAM, whereby it completely outperforms my Lenovo Legion gaming laptop with 16GB of RAM by many miles when it comes to rendering an 8-minute video clip, which is actually 1080p resolution. Now, even though 8GB of RAM is good, but is having more RAM better? Now, from my own personal experience, 8GB of RAM for my M1 MacBook Air has been suffice for 95% of the tasks I've been doing, with multiple softwares running at the same time in the background, except this one occasion whereby I was actually doing a webinar and I needed to share screen showing my video editing process. And this actually caused my M1 MacBook Air to slow down, to have some lag with the color ball showing. So I would say that having more RAM would do more good than harm. And if your budget allows, go for 16GB RAM or more. The third area to consider would be storage. The Apple MacBook Air lineup starts with 256GB of storage, while the MacBook Pro lineup starts with 512GB of storage. So if you're mainly using your MacBook for like emails, web browsing, video calls, content consumption like YouTube, Netflix, etc., and some simple tasks, and you don't see the need to back up anything in your laptop, then I feel that 256GB of storage would be sufficed. But if you're doing heavy duty stuff, and you have like many Word documents, you have huge files, your emails have large attachments and many of them, and you do see a need to do backup of all these important files, then you should at least consider 512GB or even more. The fourth area would be portability. If you're someone who moves around a lot and you need to bring your laptop around with you, I would say you'll be pretty concerned with the weight of the laptop. Now, the MacBook Air series weighs between 1.2 kg to 1.5 kg, while the MacBook Pro series weighs between 1.4 kg to 2.16 kg. The fifth area to consider would be ports. For the MacBook Air series, it has only two Thunderbolt 4 ports and one headphone jack, whereas for the MacBook Pro series, it comes with three Thunderbolt 4 ports, a full HDMI slot, and an SD card slot. For the sixth area to consider, it would actually be the display screen size. For the MacBook Air series, It comes with a screen size from 13.3 inch all the way up to 15 inch with a maximum screen brightness of 500 nits or 400 nits. For the MacBook Air, it also allows you to connect to one external monitor with a maximum resolution of 6K. Whereas on the other hand, for the MacBook Pro, you can choose from screen size of like 13.3 inch all the way up to 16.2 inch, maximum screen brightness from 500 nits all the way up to 1000 nits. And of course, MacBook Pro series allows you to connect external monitor anywhere from 1 all the way up to 4. The seventh area to consider would be battery life. All the laptops within the MacBook Air series, they can last up to 18 hours, whereas for the MacBook Pro series, the battery can last anywhere from 18 hours all the way to 22 hours. And this actually depends on the settings and the workload. Last but not least, price. The MacBook Air series starts from $1499 Singapore dollars, going all the way up to $3699 Singapore dollars, depending on your configuration. Whereas for the MacBook Pro series, it starts from $1899 Singapore dollars all the way up to $9499 Singapore dollars, depending on your configuration. Alright, so at the end of the day, after going through seven major areas to consider, how should you pick the best MacBook for you? Well, firstly, the best overall will be the 15-inch MacBook Air. It's truly a superb everyday laptop. Solid premium build quality, stunning big display, excellent performance, and exceptional battery life. The best bang for buck will go to the first generation M1 MacBook Air. It is the best entry-level MacBook, which is still available on the Apple website. Even today, it still offers excellent performance and a great battery life for a good price. The best value goes to the second generation 13.6 inch M2 MacBook Air. It is a superb machine with a fabulous lightweight design, equipped with the latest chipset, excellent and fluid performance with very little, basically nothing to complain about. If you're after an all-rounder laptop with a slightly larger display than the one mentioned before, you're looking at it right now. The best for professionals will be the M2 14-inch MacBook Pro. It is an incredible laptop with more power and performance than most will ever need or able to fully utilize. Fantastic build quality, incredible display, great battery life, and it comes with a very handy SD card slot, full HDMI slot, and it's still lightweight enough, around 1.6 kg for those business trips. The best for power and display will be the M2 16-inch MacBook Pro. Like its 14-inch cousin, this is for the heavy professionals who only want the creme de creme, power, screen, battery life, all in one slick package. The best for young professionals would actually be the M2 13.3-inch MacBook Pro. This is the perfect entry-level Pro Series MacBook for young professionals who want that extra power and battery life over the MacBook Air series, and it is able to last them for a few years until they decide to upgrade to the bigger brothers, either the 14-inch or the 16-inch. And of course, you can always check out the Apple Certified Refurbished section or other third-party platforms such as Amazon, eBay, Carousel for more savings on pre-owned MacBooks. Most importantly is to get the MacBook which best suits your needs and budget. And there you have it. This is actually my personal guide on choosing the most suitable MacBook for you. I hope you guys enjoy it. If it did, do remember to smash the like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't, and that's all the time we have. My name is Johnny. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.